And so it's very apparent that the police are only in our community, not for our security, but the security of the business owners, so to see that the status quo is kept intact.
Ladies and gentlemen, the very word secrecy is repugnant in a free and open society. And we are, as a people, inherently and historically opposed to secret society, to secret oaths, and to secret proceedings.
When it hit, you feel no pain. White folks say it controls your brain. I know better than that. That's game, and we ready for that. Two soldiers head of the pack. Matter of fact, who got the
what?
And where my army at? Rather attack and not react.
Think for yourself. Question authority.
For we are opposed around the world by a monolithic and ruthless conspiracy that relies primarily on covert means for expanding its sphere of influence, on subversion instead of elections, on intimidation instead of free choice.
This is a war against the urban guerrilla, the organizations which are mounting this nationwide war on law officers must be discovered and punished before the fabric of this nation is seriously damaged or destroyed.
There's a war going on outside, don't man escape from. There's a war going on outside, no man escape from. There's a war going on outside, no man escape from. There's a war going on outside, no man escape from.
We have before us the opportunity to forge for ourselves and for future generations a new world order.
We can be summed up in one word: evil. Let's roll.
There is an indefinable, mysterious power that pervades everything. I feel it, though I do not see it. It is this unseen power which makes itself felt and yet defies all proof, because it is so unlike all that I perceive through my senses. It transcends the senses.
I believe that Gandhi's views were the most enlightened of all the political men in our time. We should strive to do things in his spirit, not to use violence in fighting for our cause, but by non-participation in anything you believe is evil.
I think, though, that we can be sure that the vast majority of who engage in the demonstrations and who understand the nonviolent philosophy will be able to face all of the other brutal methods they use without retaliating with violence, because they understand that one of the first principles of nonviolence is a willingness to be the recipient of violence while never inflicting violence on another.